5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Greetings and salutations, my fellow Manji players. My name is Eddie, and I am back with another punishment video. This time, we're going to go after Master Raven. Yes, our extra thick brown skin goddess. And we got to do it. She gives me problems, so I'm pretty sure she gives everyone else problems. So we're going to go over her move list. And we're gonna make this work. We're gonna start off. We're probably gonna. I'm gonna skip over one and twos. One and two into haze. I wonder. I'm gonna record this. I don't think she can guard out of her haze. Of course, I don't think she's gonna do haze out of 1-2. But I don't know if this counts as an actual punish, but hey, doesn't hurt to try, right? Alright. The right straight to left low kick, that's just gonna be a high low. Probably can only punish this with Wall Rising 4. You could probably low parry that if you expect it. I did that on accident. Hold on. Did I just unveil some stuff right now? That's 32. This is 36. Holy shit. Wow, that's. Look at that. Okay. That is some shit. Okay. PK combo. High, high. It does not jail, and you can punish this. But the pushback. Pushback makes it safe. Can't punish that. But it's good to know that if you do read a high variant of this attack, you can definitely duck it. A Valkyrie Lance combo. Okay, so if she does two anything, you're probably better off ducking or even low parrying. Low parrying to punish. Valkyrie Lance combo, this is 3-3-4. This is gonna be high high. Oh, I'm sorry, middle high high. Of course. I did do training against Male Raven in Tekken Tag 2, so I do know some of this. High high, this puts her in back turn. Yep. Does this flash combo not work? It does. Oh, look at that. Okay. What? Gang, why are you doing this? Oh, it dropped. But 4-1, kind of like Shaheen's, is a high. Is really used just to catch people off guard. Chariot. Oh, okay. But she gets put in the back turn. Hydra Bite. Oops, sorry. Oh, okay. Sorry, I stayed on that move. All right. Okay. There's a low option. There's a mid option, and then there's a low option. Look at that. Of course, everyone will probably go for the low. Try to mix it up with the mids and the highs. Of course, the high you can double punish. I'm not gonna go over that too much. What I am concerned about is no sword stance. Or so I thought. I'm trying to flash this. And for some reason, I can't flash that. Not the high, what about the mid? No? Okay. I think I found what I'm supposed to do here. So after this, for some reason, flash works on the low, right? For some weird reason, the flash works on low. It does not work on the high. Then what about the mid? No, the flash does not work on the mid. But I'm gonna go back to the low and see that you can launch it in the middle of it. Despite whatever option that they may decide to do. Low option, time for the high option. Okay. Okay. I'm on to something here. And let me guess, the mid. Wow. So the key against this move isn't to flash it like a normal Yoshi player would. What you can do is when she gets down to the ground, regardless of what option that she does, you can just launch her out of it. Because there's that gap in between all three of the mix-ups. Okay. Alright, I like that. Crusader. Ah. Now that's safe. Can't do nothing about that. There's Haze. I don't know if this is a good idea. Chrono's Cutter during Haze. Oh, look at that. It's a counter hit. Death from Above. That's the unblockable from a long time ago. Look at that. Of course, this is easily whiffable. This is unblockable. You can't block this move. You're just gonna get hit in the head. So, I'm wondering something. Damn. That is something you can do. If you just think that they're going in the air. going over numerous ways to punish this move. Gotta be careful to not go in just a little too fast. Because, let me see. You can safely let her whiff this. You have plenty of time to go back up. And make her regret ever doing Haze 2. Damn it. I didn't mean to do that. This shit tracks. Then Aqua Spider, I think this is just a low. Yep. I don't even think. What? This ain't punishable? So it's completely safe. I thought Yoshimizu was a character whose stances that you didn't have to respect. Master Ravens said, her trickery you don't have to respect at all. Yeah. And it's crazy. What about blind ghost during haze? Oh shit. And there's this move. I don't think you can counter that. It's almost as if you're on point, you can just not respect this at all. But it seems like Haze 4 is the only thing that you don't have to worry about. Then there's Haze 1 plus 2. Ah. And even then, like, no respect. I don't know about flashing it, though. I can flash it, but that's something you have to read, and doing a down forward two is much easier. So against most of her options, you have a solid answer against when she goes into Haze. So long as it isn't Haze 3. So long as it isn't Haze 3, it seems like that's like the best one. Oh, and then there's White Hole. Okay. I can't trust this, though. I can't trust that at all. Tartarus? Ah, okay. Negative 10 on block. I was late on that one. It seemed like it's only jab punishable. Circling winds. Negative 10. Negative 12. Negative 13. Negative 14. Okay. So definitely negative 14. A back 2-2 would do you well, unless I don't think flashing will work. Unless. Nah, it beats Flash. Okay. Lance Kick. That's a high, isn't it? Yeah, it is. That's just a regular high. That's safe on block. It's more of an empty move. Power Crush. Power Crush mid. I knew this move was punishable. So I'm like negative 13, negative 14. So I doubt it'd be launch punishable, of course. But at least negative 14, guys. If I could do it right. Moving on. Body blow, your regular down 4 plus 1. The meat hook. Like this is her mid-high screw attack. Yep. She has a mix-up from her, huh? Yeah, bolt stunner. Oh, this is launch punishable. I did not know that at first. But it seems like there's a trick to it. They both down forward 2-3. For some reason, I think it comes out faster to me. I think it comes out a little bit faster than this. Like by a couple of frames or so. Can't flash. I didn't know that. So it's like, I doubt they'd only use this in a combo or something. Shadow snap kick. Oh, okay. I didn't expect this to be punishable. That's an empty high, though. Pendulum kick. That did say pendulum, right? Yeah, pendulum kick the shadow. Alright. Yep. Gotta sidestep this. Sidewalk this to her right, I believe. I don't know why, but that's always instinctively how I react to moves like that. I always try to see if I can do that. But then there's pendulum kick the white hole. I'm gonna record this. Pendulum kick to white hole. Okay, I have to hold up. Okay. Oops. I'm gonna do that again. Oh, it didn't save. Oh. Beat action. Thank you. It's ruined. Gotta do it again. Okay. Oh. Okay. Okay. Damn it, me. I won't cover these because these are just simple lows, I think. Ballast Fang. That doesn't crumple on block. Assassin Sting. That by itself doesn't mean much. Ah. This has some recovery on it. Can't flash it. Killer B. Oh, that low. Shinobi Cyclone. Oh shit, that move. Very mean high. I ain't gonna worry about that. That gets me kinda hit. That is launch punishable, but then there's Deadly Talon. Yeah, I figured as much. Really? If you're able to guess the low correctly, you can still launch it. Alright. That's high, high, and high. That is crazy. Oops, sorry about that. But then there's also missing Talon to White Hole. If you're on point, you're able to launch punish that. Kind of sidestep that. I can't sidestep that. Skull Smasher. That's mid high, right? Yeah, I thought so. But it jails. So. And he puts her in back turn. Skull Smasher faint. That. If they let up on that kick. Damn. Okay. I just flashed this. Alright, so don't trust that then. Don't trust Flash for that. Really? Even if you decide to wanna eat all those, you can't. But it's not launch punishment. Trying to flash that. Seems like you can. But it seems like any Skull Smasher feint that she wants to do into a low. For some reason. Ah. I don't ever spin. I know that's a perfect getaway tool, but this seems like so annoying that you would have to spin away from this. I think this is all is punishable. Oh, hello. Even then. And it goes into White Hole too. I think that's a buff from Tag too. Because in Tag 2, all of Raven's, all of that mix-up was always all launch punishable on block. But it seems like only the major one is launch punishable. Mm-hmm. Ah. Let's see. Illusion strike, illusion sweep. Block. Labyrinth, that's just, I think that's just her turning around. Yeah, it is. Blind Lance. Right. High, high. can't. Back isn't straight. Those jail. That one jails. Alright. Blinding knife. Yeah. And safe. No wonder. I didn't think so. Damn it, I'll try to sidestep that. Damn it, man. Alright. Ah, you can't neutral guard that. I tried to flash that, we get countered. That seems to be safe on block. Damn. Yeah, we gotta. Seems like something we gotta block. Okay. Hello. I don't think spinning will get me out of there. No. Then it's fanfare. Nah, okay. You can always catch her whenever she's coming in from white, from Whitehole, then that goes over to the grabs. No, wait, no, these aren't grabs. Oops. Negative 10. That's negative 13. I went over negative 12. Then. Damn it. Negative 13. Seems like it is. Spiral cannon. That's just our launcher, right? Yeah. Yep. Oh, wow. Okay. Damn, gotta be on point with this. Soul Steel, let's see. Back turn. And she comes back. Okay. Cold Massacre, let's see. Ah, okay. Seems like that's safe on block two. Okay. Oh, there's no beating that. It's high though, so. Safe on block. playing defensively, I think probably just you'd be better off just dealing with that and just trying to get away from her. Yeah. Then, of course, it goes into White Hole, and then White Hole will get her uppercut. But for the sake of it anyway, let's rock and roll. Alright. The Demon Knee. Oh, hello. Now, that too is safe on black, I think. Yeah. Trying to see if I can flash. Trying to flash it. At best, it will give me counter hit out of no sword stance. Comma kick combo? I think that's just... I thought so, yeah. Mid-high, right? Low-high, hello. Okay. If you eat the low, you eat the high. Alright. First shotgun. Okay. The Shinobi Cyclone. Aw, oh, man. This crumples are on block. You get a wall rising 2-1. Yep. That's probably her best move out of back turn. Because that will get her launched. Abyss Cannon, that was back turn, back 2-3, then back turn, back 2-4. See what this does. Oh, okay. This is probably something that you'd probably be better off eating. It's safe. It's safe on block. And I'm pretty sure if they were trying to like risk a counter hit, they would do this and then get themselves launched if you do block it. Cannon tail, back towards enemy. Back turn, back 3. Oh shit. Alright, that's very safe. Not fucking with that one. Labyrinth, let's see. Oh, she just turns back around. Alright, best move of the game. Gremlin Smasher, let's see. Ooh, no, that's safe. I think. Yeah, I think so. Yep, very safe. Vermillion. Oops. Ah, okay. If you manage to block this, there you go. I think that's the best I can get. Let's see. Oh, nope, you can launch punish that. And Phantom Warp, that's when she just backflips through your soul. I thought. Previous iterations would have her teleport through you, maybe on the other side of that. Gatekeeper. Okay. Negative 10. Negative 12. Negative 13. And negative 13, ladies and gentlemen. Deathbringers. Seems like Deathbringer, there's mid, there's Deathbringer high, and there's Deathbringer low. It tracks. Well, the first hit tracks. The second hit doesn't. Oh shit, wow, that's cheap. Does this crumple then? It does not. Okay. even if it is the low, speaking personally, this would, to me, this seems like something you're just like, okay, well, you're doing Deathbringer, I'm just gonna leave you alone. That would use, that used to be a combo. That's a mid? What? Yeah, that's safe. We can't do nothing about that. I think the only way to really stop that would be the low parry of that. Because if you get hit by the low, well, that's it. If I can even low parry this thing. If you stay away from her, you get yourself a nice cheeky punish off of that, but I don't trust that for one second. Of course, you manage to block the low. She comes in with white hole. There we go. Shadow Scythe. That move, okay. Nah, that move is safe. Stormbringer. What? Thought so. It is launch punishable. I think Yoshi can barely reach that. But he can. I like that. I like that. Chakram? What is this? This is... Oh, okay. This did get buffed. These used to be... These used to all be launch punishable. It seems like it's, like, negative 12. Negative 13, seems like. Yeah, negative 14. Because I know there's all the chakram mix-ups. Unless you get counter hit, you can just eat this low, punish that. But I think, regardless of, oh, except the super shotgun right there, that one's very definitely still launch punishable. And then there's the mix up. That's what I was expecting. Okay. So, if they do normal chakram... Oh, shit! I can flash that. Oh, my God. Okay. So, after the low hits, you can flash it. And the thing is... Hold on, let me go... Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Oh, my God. I'm sorry. If I go back to chakram... I think I can. I can't. I don't think I can eat the low and then tell me to dig with a flash. I think I have to block the low. Unless I'm in no sword stance, perhaps. Alright. No. I was too early. Yeah. Okay. This is a heavy shotgun. And even then, I can't. You have to block the low. But the thing about the low is either it gets done right away or there's a small delay. Like there's a window. There's a window that you can see that see whether a low is coming or not. Because when you do a normal shockroom, the low comes right away. And whenever you do the shockroom shadow, or maybe even the white hole, let's see. Okay. If you see the low, now I'm getting it. If you see the low, you can block the low, and you can flash it. If you get hit by the low, you can't flash it, but you can still punish it on block if you don't get countered. And then there's white hole. Then there's the spinning chakram. This is definitely launch punishable. This move is very negative. Shadow Spear. That's safe. And her flying knee. Overhead mids. Negative 10. Negative 12. Negative 13. Negative 14. Oh my god. No sword stance. Holy shit. That is some shit. Okay. Iron Maw. Oh, that's a mid, huh? I thought so. Negative 10. Seems like it's only negative 10 for Yoshi. Could be negative 11. I'm not too sure. Yoshi doesn't have an 11 frame punish. Warhound. Back 1. Back 2, I'm sorry. Now, those may as well have just been 2 mids. Because, they hit in the exact same place, but they jail. So, oh well. Pandora spin? Oh, that's our unblockable. I wonder. Didn't think so. Thought so. That's cheesy. I wouldn't trust that either. Even then, you can easily sidestep this. And words cannot explain just how negative this woman is if she does not hit you. That move is so negative. You have time to go make yourself a bowl of cereal, come back, and she's still negative. Okay. Fatal Elbow, Quarter Circle 4, series of moves. That is safe. It'll blow the haze. There's Buzzsaw. Ah, that move. Holy shit, you can launch that bad boy. Levitine. Oh, the fake out. The fake out can get you. I was trying to see something. If you're on point, you can have time to block the low, then flash whatever may happen later. Not too sure about that one. Let's see. That's a high. Can't do nothing about that. Poison eating the blind ghost. You can only get that second part if she hits you. Black hole. Hello. Something about that. Throws me off. Something tells me I could launch that, but I can't be too sure. And underground. I wonder. Okay, it's just a two hit. Nope. Wall rising. A rising uppercut. -12, 13, 14. I didn't expect this to be launch punishable at all. Jackknife elbow. The elbow is safe. Trident kick. That is safe too. Shadow snap kick. Yeah, that's safe too. Spinning middle kick. Okay, I mistook the move. Quicksand catastrophe. Ah, that move. That move is almost impossible to react to. But if you do manage to read it, crumple, baby. Which means that the options are unlimited. This crouch step. This is dead end? What the hell is dead end? Oh, okay. That happened. Supercharged, but she has a move that goes with it. And it reaches far. It reaches very, very far. Alright. Then there's the 10 hit combos, there's the grabs. Orbiting Moon, there's Undertaker. Okay. This has been Master Raven. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys learned some stuff just like I did. And I'm gonna get out of here. This has been Tekken 7. This has been Master Raven's Punishment Guide for Yoshimitsu. Peace out.